A lot of uncertain times with the incoming of that new NXT. You guys saw the new logo and everything like that. Who knows what you think about it, but I don't know. It's not looking good for NXT.
What's up, Marks?
Guys, getting this NXT review and reaction of tonight's show. Not much going on NXT. They're kind of in a holding pattern, seeing where the brand is going to take off and where it's going to end up going. Like I said, you guys saw the logo. Who knows when that's going to start? Who knows where it's headed? It's a big look, different look, obviously. No longer the black and gold. It's a bunch of splashing of colors. We'll see what goes on. This show started off, though, with Mandy Rose in her, like, first match is coming back. She's with Gigi Dolan and JC Jane. That's her crew. She's taking on Saray. You know, the match is going on. Saray drop kicks her into the ropes. And then after that, it seems like she broke her face or something like that. And that's why they were covering her up. And they
Dream Street. Saray. Ew!
Sunray drop kick to the kisser of Mandy Rose.
Up and they ran away. They later, JC Jane and Gigi Dolan will beat down Saray later on. So we'll see where this is all headed. I mean, kind of is what it is.
Yeah, I mean, at least they're trying with something. They're using the women's division for something. They're trying to throw, you know, just a new feud in there. Got a new stable coming in. We'll see where this all goes. Again, everything just feels like it's in limbo just with the whole new NXT. We're not sure what's going to stay, what's going to go, who's going to be here. It's just, it's a lot of different things going on. But this is one way to start off. I mean, there was a lot of women involved in today's show, so there's definitely a lot of women division stuff going on, so that's good.
Definitely is, yeah. Next thing on the show is Kyle O'Reilly versus Duke Hudson. Kyle O'Reilly gets the win. He's obviously on a path, collision course with Samoa Joe sooner or later for that title. Duke Hudson, though, lost in the semifinals of the breakout tournament, but he seems to be a guy that they have on the priority list, especially with the new look NXT of being a major guy there.
Yeah, I mean, he put up a good fight. He did what he had to do. He looked good. He's definitely, I mean, this is a guy that they're pushing. I mean, remember, he was on the main roster for a little bit during the beginning of the pandemic. So there's something that WWE likes about this guy. He's got a good look, and I guess they're just going to try to push him. And who knows? He might be one of the faces of, like, the next NXT, the Splash brand, whatever you're going to call it.
Yeah, he definitely could be. He seems like a guy who has the look that Vince McMahon would like. Next thing on the show, we had two NXT UK alum, or one of them being the champion. So Ilya Dragunov speaks. He's running around with a limp, messed up head. He says he's going to take on, he's still alive, more alive than ever. He's not scared of anybody. He's going to take on any challenger that comes his way. Do they go with Dragunov, Walter 3? Who knows? Kaylee Ray explaining why she came to NXT, talking trash about every woman on the roster, and how she needed her star power. Ember Moon took offense to that. So we may see Ember Moon, Kaylee Ray as the first feud before Kaylee Ray goes on to Raquel Gonzalez.
Yeah, a lot going on there. I mean, again, we're just more women stuff. I like it. I'm digging it. We're just throwing new stars. We're getting to see new feuds. So as long as they continue those things, I think we're good. But again, it's like Splash brand. We don't know. All the tie-dye. Who knows what it's all going to look like. But, you know, definitely the women's division is highlighted, and that could be a major thing going forward where the women's division is kind of maybe the focal point. You never know, or just use more. I mean, who knows?
Yeah, who knows where it's going to head and who's going to be the face of the division as the Splash comes and the whole thing changes. Next thing on the show, we had Imperium versus Drake Maverick and Grayson Waller. Not much to talk about here. Imperium gets the win. They're still there with, you know, in the hunt for those NXT tag team titles. Oni Lorcan and Danny Burch will finally get the rematch against MSK next week. So we'll see where all this heads. Not a ton to talk about here. Next thing on the show is Johnny Gargano versus LA Knight, my boy LA Knight. It's a heel versus heel match, but seemingly kind of seems that maybe turning Gargano maybe a babyface sooner rather than later. He's a little bit too entertaining to be kind of a heel right now. Now, the whole thing with Indy and Loomis, we'll see how that ends up turning out in the end when they do the wedding. I think it's next week or the week after is the wedding. So we'll see when that goes down. But, you know, Knight gets the win here because of the stuff going on the outside. But, you know, LA Knight is a guy who's main roster, seemingly main roster bound, main roster made. And Gargano, I'm not sure where he falls in all this. But we could see him turn into babyface sooner rather than later.
Yeah. You know, I don't know if he's gonna be a baby face. I think him and Dex Lumis is obviously like where that's gonna go next. I think obviously that's gonna go bad and they're gonna have to have a feud. It just kind of makes the most sense right now. I think more of like the little tweener, funny, sarcastic a-hole that he's doing right now is gonna be him. I think fans are gonna like it. They're gonna find it funny. I don't think he's gonna be like a super hot heel. Yeah. I just think he's gonna be Johnny Gargano, Johnny Wrestling. We all respect him and he does funny stuff. But yeah, that's basically where I think that's gonna go. I mean, that's the only viable option right now, I think. And LA Knight should be on SmackDown soon. It should be on or on Raw soon because I think he's kind of already outgrown NXT, especially in the direction that they're going. He really doesn't really fit.
Yeah, it really doesn't. He doesn't really fit in the kind of the spice. Pretty much everything they don't want to be in NXT.
Yeah, like a guy in his 30s.
A guy in his 30s. Yeah, he's just like, he needs to be there. He has the size and everything like that, but it's just in the look, but it's just his age. Next thing they show, Raquel Gonzalez versus Jessi Camille. Raquel Gonzalez gets the win. Now we're getting into maybe Frankie Monet getting her shot at the title against Raquel Gonzalez in the near, not too distant future. And we'll see how that goes down. She seems to be like the most viable person to kind of maybe take a title off her. Currently, her and probably Kaylee Ray, because of Kaylee Ray's history in NXT UK. So we could see that go down eventually later on. Next thing, Samoa Joe had an interview with Wade Barrett. I thought it was really well done. You know, he's such a good promo. He's such a good talker. He's very grounded, down to earth, way he speaks and the way he comes off. But he also has a hint of like, I don't know, regalness to the way he talks. So he has like a nice ebb and flow to the way he weaves in and out of his promos and stuff like that. But he basically just challenged everybody in the NXT roster who's coming. You saw what happened last week, all the new challengers that kind of stepped up to him. So we'll see who is the next guy to end up facing him.
NXT roster is going to step up. Who amongst them is going to brave the wiles of coming at me, trying to seize their destiny? These are the questions that need to be answered. Him.
Then we got Ikemenjiro versus Roger Strong, another open challenge. They're biding time to then get Strong versus Kushida whenever that's supposed to happen. I think Kushida's dealing with something, maybe COVID related or something, who knows. But Strong is the win, and that's pretty much it right there. Next thing on the show was Tommaso Ciampa versus Ridge Holland. And a pretty solid match. These guys work, the guys mix well with each other, because it's like Timothy Thatcher versus Ciampa. It's very physical, except one of these guys just a lot bigger than Thatcher and Ciampa. Ciampa gets the win, which I thought was surprising, because Holland just recently come back, right? So he gets the win, but then they beat him down afterwards, everybody involved. But then here comes MSK to help out. So Birch and Lorcan go to the outside, fight off MSK. We could get some six-man tag action coming up next week. Not next week.
Where's the NXT Tag Team Champions? And all four of these men slugging it out. Next week, NXT Tag Team title will be on.
Not next week, I'm sorry, because they have a title match maybe after that. So it looks like the title match is probably going to end kind of schmazzy with a DQ or something like that.
Yeah, I think that makes the most sense. But yeah, Ciampa versus Holland, these are my type of, you know, brawl them out, hit hard, everything looks good. I like it. I thought Holland would get the win or like some type of cheating type of win, but at least they got the heat on him afterwards. And now we're going to have a battle group versus group. So that's definitely, you know, AEW like, but I like it. I don't mind it. I like all the guys involved. They're all really good. And Ciampa, another guy. I mean, what's his future? You know, it's just like guys like Holland makes sense. Holland's a guy you can probably build around, but MSK obviously is the team they're going to build around without question. But Ciampa, Gargano, LA Knight, even Samoa Joe. Is Samoa Joe going to be the guy to carry the title? Maybe they want an established face there. There's a lot of different things that can go on. I'm intrigued. What's going on for me right now on NXT is like, I don't really care about any of the storylines really at this point. That there's some that are interesting, but right now I just want to see who stays, who goes, what the whole future of NXT is. That's where I'm more excited about, and I want to get there and see what it's all about. We got the logo, we got the new look. It's brighter, it's cheerier, it's not the black and gold brand anymore. So I don't know, it's gonna be interesting, but there's definitely a lot to look forward to, a lot of interesting things coming up on the horizon for WWE as a whole.
In all honesty, it could just be them maybe dropping some contracts down, maybe restructuring some contracts, making it hyper produced like the way the main roster is, stage, stuff like that. If they want to take that direction, or if they want to simple it down, and then they are going to get, because remember, that's a lot of rumor of the fact that they want to get younger. They want to get more of like body guys and bigger looking guys, box office guys. So it is rumor. We did get the logo. The feel of the show is going to change the look of the show. But again, it's rumor and innuendo when it comes to the fact that who's going to leave, who's going, what look are they looking for? Are they done with the over 30 guys?
It's true.
Now, they could just have a mass exodus of talent coming up to the main roster, or just released in general. But it'll be interesting to see. I think around the draft times when we may see a lot of these changes kind of implemented.
Well, so when is the draft? I've been waiting for the draft for like months. When's
that
thing happening?
I think in October now. They pushed it back to like late September, October. It was supposed to happen like around this time right now. I think past Monday Night Raw, this whole week was supposed to be like the first week of the draft. So, you know, guys, that's a review and reaction for tonight's NXT. Not much went down. It's kind of a whatever episode of NXT.
Whatever.
But we're kind of just waiting in the wings and trying to see what's going to go down, what kind of changes we're going to see. Must be the interesting thing. So with that being said, check out my NXT is Dead video and let me know what you think about that. Check out all the other videos I dropped, the pros and cons of CM Punk and AEW, and Daniel Bryan and CM Punk and AEW, and all that good stuff. Problem WWE has Roman Reigns. We'll catch you guys on the next one this Thursday, 5:15 p.m. AEW All Out prediction live stream. Make sure you tune into that. Let us know your predictions and everything like that. But we appreciate you guys for tuning in, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.
Box.